But all your fishing needs come to Captain Hook.
Following the recent fire, the city councillors would like to remind all inhabitants to proceed with regular cleaning of their chimneys.
Dangerous sleeper. While you were putting a stop to this madness, I was sniffing out who's responsible.
His tactics are familiar to me.
Is that right? Well, don't know who the man is, but he's not for Patriots nor British. He's got a fortified camp built around the main water supply in the area. All the seized crops, all the meat, everything is being moved there, then resold at dizzying prices.
How do we get in?
I got some local men ready to get in on the fight. A madman?
Not mad. Beguiled by a set of dangerous but attractive ideals.
Is that right? And who exactly are you?
Someone who seeks to relieve men like him of their power.
And after seeing what you can do, I leave it at that. But if you ever need an extra blade, I'll stand by you.
Ha ha! me!
What in God's name are you doing?
That man was a British spy. He intended to kill you, Major Arnold.
What?
General Washington learned of the plot and sent me to foil it.
Indeed. We need all the support we can muster. Some of my men are leaving on a munitions delivery to a nearby camp, and I need you to escort them. Find John Anderson upon your arrival. He'll have further instructions. Questions?
No.
Good. Third Washington sent.
Major General Arnold sent me to assist you.
Yeah? All right, he's the boss. Thank goodness you're here. Doubt we could get all these crates down to the camp without you.
You do not agree with this?
You have an Allah. We're meant to garrison West Point, and by extension, hold the Hudson. It's vital, no arguing that. So why is it we're shipping out half our powder and shot?
Why not bring up your concern with Major General Arnold?
I have. He threatened to have me court-martialed for insubordination and treason, if you can believe that. So I follow orders, no matter how absurd.
Getting away. He's supposed to be on that ship. Get after him.
You'll hang for this.
Hey, I'm not the real traitor. I could tell you who it is if you let me go. Listen. Just turn your back for 5 seconds, and you'll never see me again. I don't want anything to do with this place. Listen, mate, I know you're just following orders, but things aren't what they seem around here. I'm telling you. Money you want, because I got money. How much to set me free?
Be quiet.
All right, listen. I can fix this. Just give me a chance, and I'll prove to you I'm a real patriot. I want this country as much as the next man. Just let me show you.
That the traitor?
It is. Major General Arnold will have further orders for you.
Sounds good. Welcome aboard, m'lady.
Ah, Connor.
Just the man I wanted to see.
Well done capturing the traitor, but I must ask more of you. There are some kegs of powder resting inside the fort. Bring them to the magazine. Dismissed. Are you well?
As well as I can be, given the circumstances. You?
Same. But we're close. So very close. We need to talk about this someplace with fewer curious ears.
Has Clinton agreed?
It is done. Only the matter of my compensation remains something of the utmost importance to me. Deliver this letter. Make absolutely sure he gets it. Please be cautious. A mistake at this stage would be unfortunate. When we come out on the other side of this thing, I'll make sure you're rewarded, Major Andre. Generously.
You mean John Anderson, sir?
Yes.
Sir!
Make sure we're not followed. If anybody sees us, kill them. Far enough for you two. Keep a keen eye and come for me when you see the smoke.
Yes, sir.
We'll be waiting, Major Andre.
Halt! Gentlemen, I hope you belong to our party.
What party?
The lower party.
We do.
Good. I'm an officer in the British Army and I must not be detained. I will chalk this mishap up to fatigue.
But we ain't British, friend. And you are under arrest.
That was merely a test, and you passed. I'm an officer of the Patriots, in truth. Here are my papers.
Rubbish! Kill him and bring his head to the commander.
No! Do not kill him. Search him instead.
Blessed stars. His real name is Major Andre, and he's with the British. He carries this letter on behalf of Major General Benedict Arnold.
Arnold is our commanding officer.
Bind Andre's hands immediately and bring him to Commander Washington. I will see to Arnold.
Connor, finished already. I have some more.
Explain this.
Well, I don't know what this is.
A letter in your hand, addressed to General Clinton of the British Army, confirming the surrender of West Point for the sum of 20,000 pounds.
This must be some sort of plot to expose the fort. I'm a patriot through and through, Connor. My actions at Saratoga speak to that, I'm sure.
For your sake, I hope General Washington agrees. He will be arriving here today.
Regulars! Regulars! We're under attack! The main! Push them back!
Oh, Arnold betrayed us! That turncoat bastard!
We secure the fort, then we deal with Arnold.
Aye!
Form up! Form up! Ready to the flag! To me!
Arnold was behind this, but he escaped.
If you did not catch him, nobody could have. West Point is secure. Major Andre will hang for his crimes.
And Arnold?
We'll try to find him, though I have my doubts. Whom can we trust now? The Patriot heroes are betraying us.
You reap what you sow.
I'm over here, don't you know? Pleased to announce the opening of its new dining hall. Whatever the occasion, if you've a party, we've the space. The New York Morning Post. A penny's worth, indeed. For all your fishing needs, come to Captain Hornbill's. Whether a fleet or a weekend angler, he's got everything to make him jump out of the water. In today's New York Morning Post. The New York Morning Post. A penny's worth, indeed. Shelter and Tweed Undertakers. Count on them to provide the full range of peaceful, dignified services for your daily departing.
If we had leadership, organization,
for timber, firewood, and a vast assortment of fine wood products, rely upon Pelham Brothers, proudly serving the city since 1742. Merseyside Saddlers wishes it to be known a great clearing of leather infantry shall take place this Friday. Come equip your dubbin with the best for less. For the best rates in transatlantic shipping, contact Wells Brokers. Let us worry about the details while you get down to business. The Plough is pleased to announce the opening of its new dining hall. Whatever the occasion, if you've a party, we've the space. Shelter and Tweed Undertakers. Count on them to provide a full range of peaceful, dignified services for your daily departing. The New York Morning Post. A penny's worth indeed. For all your fishing needs, come to Captain Hornbill's. Whether a fleet or a weekend angler, he's got everything to make him jump out of the water. Shelter and Tweed Undertakers. Count on them to provide the full range of peaceful, dignified services for your daily departing. Merseyside Saddlers.
Calma.
Commander. Connor. Any word on Lee?
Not yet. My apologies. I've been distracted. Supply caravans meant for the camp have gone missing. I suspect treachery. A traitor named Benjamin Church, recently released from prison, has vanished as well. The two events are surely related.
What was his crime?
He was caught sending letters to the Loyalists, detailing our troop strength. He claimed it was a scare tactic, that we might avoid war. A poor lie.
I will find church for you.
Why? What reason have you to help?
Does it matter?
As you wish. We've received reports of trouble along the southern road. Might be he's responsible. I suggest you begin your search there.
Ah, Connor. What do you think of my work thus far?
The men are bolstered, focused. It is good you have come.
You are too kind. Lord knows my journey was far from certain. The trials we suffered getting here were strange and many. I dressed as a woman, Connor, to evade British spies. Did you know that?
I did not. As a woman, you say?
It is the truth. King George had already stopped our crossing once in Bordeaux, threatening to seize my newly purchased ship, La Victoire, and arrest me. But I was born stubborn, and such a warning could not dissuade me. So we rowed for Spain and bought passage aboard the ship there. George's spies had followed us every step of the way. Disguise was the only remaining option, mon Dieu.
No man can doubt your commitment, and you are invaluable to the cause. You did what you needed to do. I am certain I would have done the same.
But of course you would. I expect nothing less.
Any last words?
Wait. A poor choice.
Come to check up on Church? Make sure he'd stolen enough for your British brothers?
Benjamin Church is no brother of mine.
No more than the Redcoats or their idiot king.
Oh, I expected naivete, but this... The Templars do not fight for the crown.
We seek the same as you, boy. Freedom, justice, independence.
But...
But what?
Johnson, Pitcairn, Hickey. They sought to steal land, to sack towns, to murder George Washington.
Johnson sought to own the land, that we might keep it safe. Pitcairn aimed to encourage diplomacy, which you cocked up thoroughly enough to start a goddamn war. And Hickey? George Washington is a wretched leader. He's lost nearly every battle in which he's taken part. The man's racked with uncertainty and insecurity. Only look at Valley Forge to know my words are true. We're all better off without him. Look, much as I'd love to spar with you, Benjamin Church's mouth is as big as his ego. You clearly want the supplies he's stolen. I want him punished. Our interests are aligned.
What do you propose?
A truce. Perhaps some time together might do us good. You are my son, after all, and might still be saved from your ignorance. I can kill you now, if you prefer. Excellent. Shall we be off?
Do you even know where Benjamin Church has gone?
I'm afraid not. I'd hoped to ambush him when he or one of his men returned here. It seems I'm too late. They've come and cleared the place out.
I may be able to track him. There were rations inside the crates, medical supplies, and clothing as well. Snow has obscured the tracks, but enough remains that we can still follow.
Just my luck. Going to freeze to death if I don't get this fixed.
Are you Ben Church's man?
Well played.
Not wise to run.
What do you want?
Where is Benjamin Church?
I don't know. We was riding for a camp just north of here. It's where we'd normally unload the cargo. Maybe you'll find him there.
Enough of that.
You did not have to kill him.
Let's not waste time with all this pointless banter. Go catch up with the rest of Church's men. Infiltrate that camp of theirs and see what you can discover.
And what about you?
Never you mind. Just do as I ask.
To go.
All they need to do is raise the lights back. They should have done that a long time ago.
All this fight serves no purpose. The crowd's sure to win in the end. To waste all those lives chasing a fool notion breaks my heart, it does.
looks to be in order. Go and see the foreman. There's another run planned for tonight.
I'll go bring the wagon in.
Thanking me when you hear why he's got a plan.
About time you showed up. Listen here. Boss wants us to try something new tonight. A raid. No more convoys. We're to steal from the Yank camp itself.
Valley Forge?
That's right.
You sure about this?
It's not my business to be sure or not sure. I just do as Church asks. If you're so concerned, take it up with him.
Is he here?
Of course not. Hiding in New York, the last I heard. Trying to keep a low profile. What, on account of him not wanting to go back to jail and all.
All right, I'm in.
Look what we found.
He was creeping around the camp, all suspicious-like.
Must be a Yank spy.
He's something else. Something special. Isn't that right, Haytham? Church told me all about you.
Then you should know better than this.
You're not really in a position to be making threats, are you?
Not yet.
Have a minute, my friend?
Is it coming, Big Dave? You make any progress on the knife? I would like to give it to Miriam soon.
The steel Norris smelted is something else. I've rarely seen such fine metal. The trouble is, my old tools aren't hard enough to work it. But the ones I need aren't hard to find. A shop or two in New York sell them at a good price. I'd do it myself, but with the regulars after my head, I'll stay here safe and sound if I can.
I have matters to attend to in New York. I will see to it the next time I journey there.
Sounds good.
Day, Connor. I left some bolts of fine silk in my old home. They are very valuable, but I don't think it wise I return there. Someone might wind up dead. I was hoping you could retrieve them for me if you had time.
Excuse me. Might I impose upon the kindness in your heart to give bed and board to a weary traveler?
Oh, traveler from where?
Across an ocean. London.
English!
Rest assured, I'm not the king's man. A great kindness. Bless you.
We work hard for what we have here, old man. What is it you do exactly?
I wish to provide God for those who seek his salvation, not spoon-feed his word to those who already have their own. An outlook not shared by the monarchy.
Lord knows some of us have things to confess.
Ollie and I have been missing our Sunday Mass.
I'd like Maria to read the Bible. I'm sure if we all pitched in, we could build a church. If you'd be our pastor. Connor?
Welcome, Minister...
Father. Father Timothy. Bless you. This will build a fine place of worship. I am most grateful.
Thank you.
Somebody! Likona! Take the Lord!
Prudence, are you all right? What are you doing out here in the woods?
Thank goodness! The baby's coming!
We need to get you to Dr. White.
No! I can't move! Take my horse! Bring him here! Go!
Dr. White, come with me now.
What's wrong?
Prudence is in labor in the forest.
In the forest? What in bloody hell is she doing out there?
Does not matter.
We need to get Warren.
Now?
Yes!
Warren, are you here?
Over here. What's the trouble? Where is she?
Tell me how she seemed to you.
In great pain. She could not move herself.
Was she pale? Was there blood?
Not that I saw.
Might be we have some time.
We must hurry.
Hello, Doctor. I think I can manage at the moment.
Is she all right, Doctor?
No, she's not all right. She's having a baby, and here, by the looks of it. Yes. Looks to be in fine health as well. Has a good set of lungs on him. Now, I don't mean to rush you, but we need to get both you and... Does he have a name yet?
Hunter. Smoke, Connor?
No, thank you.
We were just recalling the eventful day of little Hunter's birth.
I am not sure I have ever been so anxious.
Ha!
I barely remember a thing up until the moment I heard him cry. Then it all slows down, and I recall every little detail. From Hunter's wailing face, to Prudence's teary eyes filled with pure love, to the smell of the mud and the leaves. I've never been as happy as I was in that instant.
Things in this house sound right.
Again? What do you got for me? Blow me or you've earned the last of these blasted things. Be sure to let me know what you find, eh?
I don't mean to be a bother, but I wanted to ask you something. When my cart went up in flames, I lost most of my tools. I've got some spares back at my shop in Boston, but as you know, I'm not really welcome around there. I thought if it wasn't too much trouble, you could help me retrieve them.
What would you have me do?
Watch my back while I gather them. Meet me in Boston at my old shop.
Ah, it's good to be at sea again, but I don't much like that sky.
Even a pretty sunrise is a bad omen to you, Mr. Faulkner. Where are these raiders?
By guessing by God, an easterly course toward the coast. Miss Mandy reports of some British boats gathering somewhere in these rocks, threatening the vineyard. British gunboats after one of the vineyard ships, Captain.
We need to keep the gunboats off until she reaches the vineyard pier.
What are you doing, Captain? That ship needs our help. Captain. Destroy them or use them to our advantage. Either way, avoid the blasted things.
To our advantage, how?
Shoot the blooming things with our swivels when our targets get too close. She should be safe now, but it's a hot chase. Get after them and end the threat on the vineyard. They veered north. Naught there but an abandoned fort. Shouldn't be there.
Well, it is there, Mr. Faulkner.
And it's too close to the vineyard. Diamond tide waits for no man. Take out her towers.
Nice driving, Captain.
Thank you. won't be troubling anybody no more. Bloody English have gone too far this time.
That is the problem. What reason would the English have to threaten Martha's Vineyard? It has no strategic value and its people remain peaceful. I fear an influence of a different kind saw to this.
Templars.
But what they intend, I do not know.
Your orders?
I need time to piece things together. We set a course for home.
Aye, aye. Ship's graveyard's just around the point. Can't miss it. The men say Abel Owens was aboard one of the doomed vessels. If it's true, you'll find what's left of him here. Scavengers love the graveyard, so be on your guard.
If Abel Owen's ship wrecked around here, they must have been looking for something themselves.
I found it!
What you carry is mine!
Nice try!
Not that easy.
Give me what I came for!
Ha-ha! What's mine is mine, Ratty Pong.
Hand it over!
Sorry, mate. Looks like you lost this treasure hunt.
Gone.
Near the wolf's abode. Joseph Palmer retired to Jamaica, somewhere around this castle. Faulkner said the scroll would likely have ended up in Lord Lewis Hutchinson's private museum. This place has seen much evil. Thank you. Hutchinson's personal museum. Kid's scroll must be here somewhere. The shot must have come from the balcony. The killer must have chased his prey, but through where? The mechanism of the mask is broken. Thank you. I do not understand how anyone could live here. Small wonder Hutchinson went mad. This place feels mad. There must be some clues around that can help me with this. Close to a tree kissed by fire.
port doesn't look as abandoned as it should. Looks occupied as can be.
I will need something to draw their attention then. Once you lose sight of me, wait for 10 minutes, then bombard the fort. I will slip out under cover of the shelling.
Aye, aye, sir. Sounds a trifle dangerous, but I'm sure you're up to it. I doubt they let convicted pirates like old Lucky Lem out of his cell much, so if his little scroll is anywhere, it's there.
Form ranks! Present arms! Position one! Position two!
I will have to circle around to avoid the courtyard.
Nah, it's probably a gull or a wreck. The only intruders we get here anyway. Preposterous. Send me across the ocean to play sentry on some meaningless isle. This is my last tour for a certainty. When I see the captain, I'll...
Ever attack this fort, I ask you? Nobody. No reason to. They sent us here because the captain did something wrong.
Like what?
Buggered if I know.
I wager he buggered something. Come off it. And keep watch.
Yeah, yeah.
Double time! We'll get a whip if we're late for the captain's address.
I'm hurrying. I'm hurrying. Comment on strategy, nor are you aware of rebel movements. So put a stop to it. The next man I hear questioning the validity of our post will receive 10 lashes and 7 days in the old dungeon without ration. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Check the dirt sheet for duties and details for the coming week. B Company will be in Brill and without rum ration.
Lurcher is out of his head. Who would do that to a man? That's why you don't let soldiers get bored.
Jack and Abe deserved everything he got. He won't tolerate such behavior. Let that be a lesson to the rest of you.
He didn't mean anything by what he said.
Well, you're getting soft.
I just don't think it's right.
Lies under the eagle's bed.
Let's see what you got, Rebel.
Under attack! Captain's dead! Cut down my cap!
You're late, Captain.
Those occupying the fort were less than thrilled by my presence.
And?
And what?
The damn scroll, you muckworm. Was it there?
That it was, Mr. Faulkner.